Amigos de Pío Deportes, estamos con Tony Clark. Tony Clark, ex jugador del béisbol de las Grandes Ligas, actual presidente de la Asociación de Jugadores de la MLB. Thanks a lot, Tony, for being here with us. We really appreciate for you taking your time to talk to us.
It's my pleasure. Thanks for having me.
Tony, right now, what can you say about the state of the Dominican League?
Well, the Dominican League, and part of the reason that we're here is to have an opportunity to come out and enjoy it. I never had an opportunity to play winter ball, so the last few years, being able to come down, see the guys, enjoy the league, and spend time watching the quality baseball that's played here is something that I enjoy doing.
Bien, le preguntamos que hasta el momento cómo él ve el estado actual de la Liga Dominicana de Béisbol, y nos dice que justamente el hecho de él estar acá es para ver el deporte, ver el béisbol. Nunca tuvo la oportunidad de jugar en el verano, y que entiende la calidad y la cualidad que obtienen los peloteros a través de estas ligas. Tony, talk to us about your experience as in the Players Association.
Well, I was done playing in the big leagues in 2009. I had an opportunity to come on board and support the players, and I looked forward to that opportunity and took it, and it's led me here. So, again, having an opportunity to stay connected to the guys and make sure that their interests and their rights are protected is something that I enjoy doing.
Le preguntamos cuál ha sido su experiencia en relación a su actividad como parte de la Asociación de Jugadores de la MLB. Nos dice que una vez terminó de jugar, él entendió que era necesario mantenerse en contacto con los jugadores, proteger sus derechos, todo lo relativo a ellos, y por eso decidió ser parte de esta asociación. So far, what do you think has been your biggest challenge as a head of MLBPA?
The biggest challenge is the travel. You know, I was fortunate when I played to travel quite a bit when I was playing, and when I got done playing, I had no interest in traveling much beyond that. But now traveling quite a bit. But again, it brings me to places like the DR and an opportunity to enjoy some things that I hadn't had an opportunity to enjoy and see guys that I hadn't seen in a while.
Le preguntamos cuál ha sido el reto más grande que ha tenido que enfrentarse como directivo de la Asociación de Jugadores de la MLB, y nos dice que sin duda alguna el hecho de estar viajando. El hombre nos dice que algo que no le gustaba era justamente el tener que viajar, y eso es algo que ha tenido que hacer como parte de la Asociación de Jugadores de MLB. So, Tony, one last question. If you had to point out something good about Dominican players, what would that be?
Their love and passion for the game. It's always something I enjoy when you come out to the ballpark and you see the players playing, young or old, and you realize that there's no place that they would rather be than on the field playing baseball, and that's something that I really enjoy coming down and seeing.
Bien, le preguntamos si él tiene que apuntar algo sobre los jugadores dominicanos. Nos dice que sin duda alguna su pasión y amor hacia el juego. Él le gusta ver cómo estos jugadores, le gusta estar más que nada en el terreno de juego, y eso le gusta ver, luego le gusta verlo. All right, Tony, thanks a lot for being here with us. We really appreciate. We hope you have a nice stay here in Dominican Republic, and we hope you come back too.
Gracias por todo. It's been fantastic. It's been fantastic, and I'm looking forward to a good game tonight.
Bien, ahí estuvo Tony Clark, ejecutivo de la Asociación de Jugadores de la MLB. Para Pío Deportes, Fabricio Geraldino.
We'll be right back.